This is John from Let's Talk Outdoors and squidlures.com. I'm down at Boardman, Oregon on the Columbia River with Charlie Foster, and we figured out yesterday we've been fishing now for 24 years.
Yeah.
And we had to come up river because the lower river closed. And yesterday we had a great day. What did we do yesterday?
We got two monster fish. We had two fish for a total weight of about 108 pounds, somewhere in there. We got a 50 incher that weighed 64 pounds.
That
probably
was
the biggest 50 incher I've seen. The quality of fish up here far exceed the lower river fish. You don't have the pressure as the lower river, and it just makes it a very unique fishery.
Yeah, so the water temperature is a little bit warmer, so hopefully the fish are a little bit more active than down in the lower river. But what are we going to do today?
We're going to go down and work the power lines in the deep water. The water temperature is starting to drop. That's going to drive them deep. Last year we were running 35 degree water temp for the whole month of January into February, and it was a great fishery, so that's what we're banking on today.
So how long is this going to last? So if somebody wants to go on a sturgeon trip this year or next year, what do they need to do?
It the season starts up, it's a Monday, Wednesday, Saturday below John Day Dam. I don't fish Bonneville Pool anymore because of the influx of people.
Yeah.
Up here it's a 7 day a week season, and normally it'll go through February 7th. We've got a bunch of nasty weather starting tomorrow, and it's gonna put the kibosh on it for about 10-12 days. So we're gonna wait for the water to warm back up. This year I'm thinking February 10th, it's probably gonna be the end of it.
All right, how to get a hold of you?
Yeah, just give me a buzz or shoot me a text on my cell phone, 503-820-1189, or you can go to the website, nwsturgeonadventures.com, and get a hold of my wife, Danny. She does all the booking. That's 503-805-5964.
All right, let's go fishing.
Sounds good.
All right, you're hooked up. Si, what do you got there?
I believe a sturgeon, brother.
What do you think this one is, Charlie?
52.
You guessed the last one right on.
44.
44 is the guess.
38.
It'll take off here in a minute.
How does it feel, Si?
It feels heavy. There he is.
That's a keeper.
Oh, that's a nice one.
What did I say?
44.
How about that? Wow, good job.
Fatty.
Nice, buddy.
All right, time to measure. I'm gonna come over here.
I won $100 one time. Somebody said 38, and I said 44, and
then they. All right, help hold him, Si.
You've been doing this for a while. You want to do it, Si?
I don't know what I'm doing here.
Hold his head straight.
Nope, just hold it, push him straight down on the bottom.
Hold that tape straight on his snout.
As soon as he quits moving.
Yeah, he's a fucking...
John, kick him right in the belly. There you go. Call that 4'6".
46! All right, hold him up, Cyborg.
Fatty is.
Yep. That's exciting.
There
you go, buddy.
Thank you.
So squid, I cut the tentacles off again. There's not a lot of scent in there. I cut the end of the squid off because sometimes you'll get air trapped in there and your bait will float. So I'm going to push that right through the head. Pull that. Push your shank of your hook down inside the squid. That'll give your squid dexterity. Sturgeon's mouth like that. Sometimes if you got a stiff bait, you won't get it down in there where it should be. So again, push your shank down inside. Take your squid guts from the other one. You're basically going to wrap that up
It's a magic thread.
Yep. We're going to grab a couple worms.
And again, you cut the ends off to get the stink to come out, which I'd never thought of, but that's a great idea.
You just got to trim them up just a little bit.
Definitely these fish are keen in on the squid and the night crawler.
Yeah, 100%. And then you just hook that worm right in the center.
So that's basically creating a bunch of tentacles that are big worms.
I'm just going to finish wrapping it up. Just do a couple simple half hitches.
With the
magic thread.
Magic thread, okay.
Now when that's done, you're going to come up and half hitch your body. And it's going to sit just like that. It's the bait of all baits.
Perfect. All right, let's get that out there. So you like to get it out past the back of the boat a bit.
Yeah, you're gonna swing around here with the current and the wind and all that. So try to create a straight line with all your rods. That way you're maximizing your scent line.
And then you have fairly loose. You don't have it tight to the bottom so that when we're moving, it's not picking it up.
Yeah, we're going to try to put probably 10 to 15 feet of slack in each line. When we do get a bite, we're just going to power crank it until the rod loads up. As soon as the rod loads up, hit them hard.
Well, the important thing is leave it in the rod holder
and
crank until it bends over and then bring it out and set the hook.
If you pull that rod out of the rod holder, chances are they're going to feel it. They're going to drop that bait instantly.
All right, let's try and get another one then.
Deal.